welcome everyone. Being born in the 80s and growing up in the 90s, I think I was exposed to some of the greatest franchises ever. In 1992, Mortal Kombat hit the shelves, arguably the best fighter game ever made. Yeah, you heard me, the best fighter game ever made. The game was released by Midway Games in first an arcade, and then for the Sega Genesis, the Game Gear, and the Game Boy. The controversy that surrounded the game violence was unseen in the time of this game. It only made me and other young kids want it more. The original game was followed by over 20 more games in the last 28 years. The franchise even took a stab at some movies that are usually loved or hated. I'm very nostalgic for these movies and will watch them at least once a year. If you are anything like me, you will stop and look at anything that says Mortal Kombat. So once I saw that somebody had released a line of masks of the characters from the video game, I hit that order button. I have three masks I want to show you. The first one is the infamous Baraka. Baraka is a character that appeared in the Mortal Kombat 2 video game. He is a race of nomadic mutants called the Tarkantan. They are a crossbreed between the Netherrealm demons and the Deezons from the wastelands of the Outworld. This mask was created by Mask Illusions, which is just a division of Ruby's costumes. I believe all three of these masks were released in 2012. If only one character from the Mortal Kombat game deserves to be turned into a mask, it is Baraka. His teeth make up for an amazing characterization in a mask. Look how big these teeth are. Now, when comparing the mask to the video games, the teeth are definitely widened. The mask is closer to the look of the Baraka in the Mortal Kombat Annihilation movie. Shane Harrison, Matt Jordan, and Chris Loynes were part of the team that did the makeup for that movie. Now, look at this bald head and pointed ears. Does it remind you of a nostalgic monster from cinema history? Baraka was created when a designer bought a Nosferatu mask and added large teeth. Look at this comparison right here. So, this character was designed after a mask. How freaking cool is that? This is a big mask that will fit a medium to large head. It's got great eye holes and ventilation. I have had it for a few years and it still is nice and flexible. It's not a thick mask, but it definitely will hold up. This is a fun mask of a great character. But now, I want to move on to Sub-Zero.
Sub-Zero wins.
I have already reviewed this mask in a previous episode, so I will make this short. There's a link to that review down in the description. I think this is an okay mask. The mouth shield and the hood would lead me to believe it was molded after the Sub-Zero from the Mortal Kombat Armageddon game, and a few games after that. I wish there was a mask based on the original character from 1992. I have seen various mouth covers that people make. There are plenty of variations of those. This is the deluxe Sub-Zero mask. They made some without the face in the sculpt. Your face would just be seen where you see the flesh on this mask. For those video game nerds out there, having Sub-Zero on your walls is a great choice. Now, I wanted to show you a mask that I just added to the collection. This is the deluxe Scorpion mask from Mask Illusions. This mask looks like it was molded after the Mortal Kombat 9 video game Scorpion. This version of Scorpion's mask is by far the most elaborate mask he has donned since the game's inception. The hood does not look like cloth. Instead, it looks like interconnecting pieces of armor. The mouth cover has more of a gold color than a yellow. I was disappointed when I opened this mask. It was shipped in a 5-inch by 7-inch plastic bag. Jesus. the mask was folded twice to force it to fit into the bag. As a result of folding it, they created permanent damage to the mask. I call this a prolapsed eye. It has happened a few times before with masks that were folded during shipping. Instead of the eye folding in like it does on the left, now this mask being folded, compressed, sitting on a hot porch for a few hours will result in the material being trained to pop out like this. Now I'm going to take the heat gun and try and remold the material so it looks better. Hopefully that will do the work. So distributors and companies, do not fold your masks. You ruin them. I was only disappointed because I really liked the sculpt on this mask. Look at the elaborate design of the mouth guard. I like how they put the look of the metal mesh on the sides of the mouth covering. The gold wraps up around the eyes and has a very distinct Mortal Kombat design to it. The hood design is even carried down to the neck with this little point here at the bottom. It's a large mask with good eye holes and ventilation. And my hope is that not all of these Scorpion masks are folded. So I do think it's worth it to take a chance and order one. Maybe just go through a company that has an easy return process in case this happens to yours. I found it on Amazon for $30 and I'll put that link down there below. Well, while these are definitely not high quality masks, they are the only officially licensed Mortal Kombat masks on the market. I would love for Mortal Kombat masks to be re-licensed to Trick or Treat Studios or Zagoni Studios. I bet they would do them justice. But if you are a Mortal Kombat fan, you will appreciate these masks for what they stand for. An epic game franchise that made a lasting impression on our popular culture. Well, with that, I will end on my favorite fatality.
Baraka wins. Fatality.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, and remember, follow your passion.